get strapped in. It's just about time to get the party started. And we are underway in Southern California. And this will go as a touchback, and they will begin things at the 25. Right to the air is Rodgers. Chargers able to get the pressure and bring him down. Credit the sack to Joey Bosa. So an early wake-up call there leads to a quick second and long. Another try after the first down sack. Rodgers, that is caught. It's the tight end, Tunyon. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Well, the first drive here and the first time that we've called a big tight end's name, but I can assure you this, Charles, it won't be the last.
No, it won't, because when he gets going, now it opens up opportunities on the perimeter, because that'll draw the defense towards him in the middle of the field. Now your wide receivers will get involved as this game goes on.
On first down, Rodgers. He finds Randall Cobb with a completion.
And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line.
So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 46. To throw is Rodgers. That's complete, and once again, it's Cobb. And he's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line. Off the play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. Caught by Cobb. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. The end result, 21 yards.
A lot of precision being shown on this opening drive. They've been methodical, they've been crisp, and as a reward, they're going to be set up with an early first and goal.
First and goal, a chance for an early statement here on the road. Play action. Now it's Rodgers. That is caught by Cobb, and it's a Packer touchdown. A 7-yard touchdown grab, and the Packers will jump on top with the game's first score here this afternoon. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise, as this one stays a 6-0 game. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. DeAndre Carter now from his end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. At their own 24-yard line. Herbert and the Chargers now with a first and 10 at their own 24. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Finds the open man. It's Mike Williams. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and that's going to bring up second down. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown in the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so offense has to be ready. Each and every.
That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked off by Darnell Savage. And the Packers are going to take possession of the football.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
So after the INT, it's Rodgers. Open man, here's Cobb. And finally,
And down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. Just like that, a pickup of 20 on their first play from scrimmage. From the gun, it's Rodgers. Now the pressure gets there, and he goes down just inside the 20 at the 19. First down, a bit of a disaster, and now on second and goal, back even further. On play action, now Rodgers looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Nasir Adderley, and the Chargers are going to have it here as they'll start at their own 24-yard line.
And as we've seen, points have been precious so far, and they just threw something away on that snap. And look, let's face it, as we advance further into this game, that play will be on the minds of everyone who's watching it. They wonder if this is the turning point. Is this the spot where those points were given away? It could cost them a ball game.
The Charger drive about to get going.
And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guys, you know, they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes, get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
Throwing again on second and 10, Herbert. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure, or do they play coverage on this down?
Going to throw on third down with Herbert. That's caught by his tight end, Gerald Everett. And he is going to have the Chargers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field, right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
Put your head in the game, head in the game, head in the game, head in the game, head in the game.
I'm whipping the track, I was left up suspension. I drove it so fast that I blew out the engine. I kept it 2 mil ever since the beginning. I play offensive D, I might switch my position. La mama was thirsty, so I had to quench. I'ma drive real fast, cause you know I shoot quick. Just like Travis Kelce, I be having emotions. Just like a lamb, I ain't know I'm exploding. My heart cold, bad, I ain't got emotions. I'm going hard, yeah, you know I'm devoted. We running streets, yeah, you know we control it. She love the kids, she be busting it open. I'm quarterbacking like I'm Kyler Murray. Trying to win, I'm up at practice early. Going crazy, I just run the jersey. It's the first half and we done dropped 30.
We just underscoring them, boy, man.
I told my boys, it ain't no limits. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limits. Put your head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head in the game.
Money on my mind, head in the game. It's like I scored again, diamonds on them dance. I can hear the music playing with the band. Crowd going wild, dived in the fans. I'm locking in on a mission, I'm turning my vision. You young as she get like me. I got your shorty, she with me. I gave her a jersey, I told her to join my team. It's best you go where it's safe. You know how I play, I get to a sack like Frank. You can teach money to fly, I turn it a hop. I catch it and go to the bank. It's crazy, I'm used to the lights, I'm shining so bright. It's visor to cover my face. You see me working and working, I'm getting it done. And soon they be feeding me grapes.
Yeah. I told my boss, it ain't no limits. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limits. Put your head in.
Well, we are about 10 miles or so southwest of downtown Los Angeles at SoFi Stadium in Inglewood. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the San Francisco 49ers and the Los Angeles Chargers. Northern California visits Southern California. The Niners and Chargers, off we go from L.A.
And they will elect to not bring this one out as our first drive will begin at the 25. Drive begins with a run by McCaffrey. And a short pickup to about the 27. It'll be second down.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
It'll be a gain of five, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now it's third down.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
That's a third down conversion of 24 yards there. Nice play.
Normally on third down and short yardage, you're thinking of throwing to your tight end. It's just going to be a simple chain mover. But this time they let him roam down the field, and a nice dart picks up the first down and then some.
And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. So nothing there that time, and maybe you need to look to the O-line. They weren't able to create any space.
No, they weren't, and you know as well as I do, as many offensive line coaches we've ever met, I think that'll be addressed loudly when those guys get to the sideline.
And they're usually loud and big. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers 33. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Out of the pistol, McCaffrey. And he struggles to get a yard here, maybe a yard, down to the 31.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Another run with McCaffrey on second down. And he's able to motor his way down to the 16-yard line. 15 for the Niners there to first down. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script. You go through your play calling. You go through all the stuff and establish things. And it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he'll get four there, down to about the 12-yard line. The pickup of four. Here's second and six. Shotgun now with Purdy. This will be caught at about the six. And the 49ers are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the five. Well, no question, this is exactly how they wanted to start this football game. And nice pass there. Now they're set up beautifully, Charles, to finish this off with a touchdown.
Yeah, but they've still got to finish it off, partner, and that means they've got to execute at this stage of the field. So we've seen many teams march it right to the goal line and not cash in. They've got something dialed up here that puts it in the end zone.
It's a loss of two there, bringing out second down.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
No score after one on EA Sports.
Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. Purdy now to throw off the play action. And he hauls it in the end zone. Touchdown, San Francisco. Tyler Croft from 8 yards out. And the Niners post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. They'll try and throw for it. It's caught. And it's 8-0. So what do you make of that? You go on the road, you score the opening drive touchdown, opt to go for two, and all of a sudden they're up 8-0.
Yeah, this wasn't a decision that they made right here and right now. They made this decision during the week. Hey, if we get the ball and score right away, let's show them that we feel like we're superior. Go for two and really put the pressure on them.
Oh, good return up past the 30. Past midfield. 30. 10. 5. And he will score. Touchdown, Chargers. Well, there you go. They gave up the score to start the game, and as quick as they could get it back, they did on the return.
And people talk about this all the time, whether you're coaching it, whether you're trying to work on it, whether you're just trying to put in the minds of your players. Attack back as fast as you can after giving up a score. No quicker way than on a kick return.
Extra point splits the uprights. And this is now a one-point game. So now the other return teams out there as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. And we will not see an attempt to match that return touchdown as this will be a touchback and bring it out to the 25. Set to get this drive underway. The offense coming back out here. Plenty of energy, ready to roll, looking to just add to what they have been doing after scoring a touchdown, Charles, their last time out.
And that's a great feeling to have on the sideline, partner, knowing you just run the battle against the opposing defense. And since they came off the field, I'll guarantee you all they want to do is get back out there because they know they have the upper hand on that defense right now.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Purdy off the play fake. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Play action is supposed to be used to slow down pressure, slow down blitzes. In this case, though, if it takes a little too long to develop, you got people right in your face.
And lucky just to get rid of the ball with the arm going forward. Could have been a fumble. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Play action, and now here's Purdy to throw it.
And that will be incomplete.
Nice back-to-back plays defensively. They're stacking momentum now. One incompletion, two incompletions. They're going for more.
On fourth down, the Niners trot out Mitch Wishnowski to punt the football. DeAndre Carter back deep. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over. Herbert going to lead up the Chargers here, first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Able to hook up with Williams here on the out route. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. Rush coming, and he's taken down.
The corner blitz gets there as he goes down for a loss of 7.
Oh, my goodness. Was that a defensive back that got to him with the pressure?
Oh, look at the former defensive back. You're all smiles up here.
I hope everybody can hear my smile on that play.
Throwing on 2nd and long. Herbert. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. The Chargers passing game rolling a bit here. They've got another first.
And this is something you don't see too much of. Fullbacks trying to stretch the field. But he does a nice job there getting lost out in space and comes up with a really nice game.
Throwing on 1st down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still 2 more downs to connect and try and pick up another 1st down.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. Off the play fake to Eckler, it's Herbert. Oh, ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Jimmy Ward. And the 49ers are going to take over here up near the 40. Well, when I looked down, he was kind of shaking his head right after he threw that pass. What did you see?
Well, from a defense's perspective, anytime you have your eyes back towards the quarterback, you're in a position to make a play on the ball, whether it's a big-time play by you or an overthrow by the quarterback. You have a much better opportunity.
They'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
Well, it's almost football 101 that you preach to your safeties. Don't let anyone get behind you, the last line of defense. But he didn't let the play come to him. He went to the play. How about that read and recognition and finishing off that one behind the line of scrimmage?
Second and 11 now. Purdy. Blitz coming and down he goes. Kenneth Murray leading the surge there as he drops it for a loss of 6. Now Charles dealing with a 3rd and long. They'll have to try to go back to the air again, and this is going to avoid the sack.
Certainly hard to try to establish momentum when all you're doing is going backwards, not protecting the passer, and he gets dumped on his backside.
Of their timeouts as he'll talk it over here before what'll be an important 3rd down. To throw, Purdy. That's complete. It's Brandon Ayuk. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And that's going to bring up a 4th down. Try. Here's Purdy. And looking for Kittle, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Nasir Adderley. And the Chargers are going to take possession of the football. The rookie was trying to push it downfield, but the safety bit him.
And he'll learn that you have to hold the safety. And you do that with your head movement, your eyes, sometimes your shoulders. Hold the safety so that you can get back to the throw that you really want to make. He got so excited thinking his guy was open that he made it easy for the defensive back to go get the football.
He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone.
That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
That was nice work there defensively to force the incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
He's got his man. That's Everett, the tight end. Well, the Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Justin Herbert looking to pass. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
But there's an incompletion, partner, and the struggles through the air continue because so far their lack of passing production has led to a lack of points.
To the air again, Herbert. And it's caught. Touchdown, Chargers. Keenan Allen with a touchdown reception from Justin Herbert. And the Chargers will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half. Play after, right down the middle. And that makes this a 14-8 ball game. The kick unit on here for the Chargers as they will send this one away.
The football will come out to the 25 as McCloud will not return it. Set to get this drive underway. With this slim deficit closing in on the end of the first half, we'll see if they can move this at least into field goal range and try to get three out of this drive.
And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Here's Purdy.
And it's knocked away and incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage. Able to knock that one away.
This time they stay on the ground. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. So the Chargers will start the second half with the lead and the football as we're underway in the third quarter.
DeAndre Carter now from his end zone. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
The Charger drive about to get going. Herbert setting up to throw on first down. That's complete to the tight end, Everett. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10.
Down to about the 45.
The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. Play action this time for Justin Herbert. Out left, he's got it to Everett. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. The catch and run, good for 24 yards.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Then their backs up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
This is caught. Touchdown! Touchdown reception from Justin Herbert. And the Chargers take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Brandon Staley telling his troops to stay out there and go for two. And they'll have Herbert try and throw for it. Firing quickly, but it's incomplete.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of two-point tries and see what the data tells us. Because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the three to the two, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
A three-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. Play action. Now Purdy. The tight end Kittle has it on the left side. And that's good for a gain of six. And they're going to face a third down. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Purdy with it on third and long. Again to the big tight end, George Kittle. And his bid for the first down coming up short as he's tackled at the 25. They'll give him 4 yards there. And that's going to make it fourth down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route. And he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn the field and gain any yardage.
And he is going to have a 49ers first down, as that'll be a gain of 15 on fourth.
How about them biting off 15 yards there on the fourth down attempt and keeping the drive alive? Up the gut, McCaffrey. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
On second down and four, Purdy. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection.
From the shotgun to McCaffrey. And he's going to get stopped up quickly. Give him a yard down to the 43. As they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. On second and nine, Purdy. Completes it to the tight end, Kittle. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers 30. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
Down, Shotgun handoff now to McCaffrey. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top plays that these guys like to run. The best runs for the top running back, those are the ones you focus on and want to take away. And they've done that pretty successfully in this game.
And he'll be close to a first down at the Chargers 22. The Niners on third down. Just one for five to this point. This time they face a third and two. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
There's no question that coming into this game, this defense is pretty vocal about his desire to take this running back out of his game. And all that pregame whooping has turned into results.
Purdy, big fourth down play. And it's going to be batted down. It will go the other way with the football. The Niners go for it, but it doesn't work out. And the Charger defense stands tall, and they get the football back. The Charger drive about to get going. Big stop on the turnover on downs to get the football back, and now it's just all about salting this one away.
Yeah, just slowly bleed the clock away. Clock's definitely on your side. And, you know, when we talk about analytics in the game, what is this one, the advanced win metrics? Because if you take care of the football here and bleed the clock down, with about 95% chance of
winning. Oh, yeah, I'd say 95 or better. I know you always say it, every coach does. It's just protecting the football at this point.
And knowing that the defensive guys, they're coming after the ball more than they are the person. They want to knock it free.
It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Charger first.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. With the late lead, Herbert's going to throw it. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Williams. And they're going to get this up to midfield.
12 more yards. That's another Chargers first down.
Running on first down, Eckler. And some room to maneuver. And a good job of finding the open space to run as he's down close to the 30 here.
19 more yards. That's another Chargers first down.
First down, and they stick with Eckler. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 45 yards rushing for him now. He's only carried the ball four times.
Starting to become a tough spot for this defense. You're down fourth quarter. Looking a little fatigued maybe on that side of the ball.
Partner, we've seen this before, haven't we? Because every coach we've ever talked to says body language is important. And now you're seeing guys with their hands on their hips, they're bent over, hands on their knees. And the offensive guys are just saying, let's just keep running it out. We've got them now.
Now one final throw here is incomplete, and that is how this one will come to an end. So this one's over. It's in the win column for the L.A. Chargers. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment went.
Monkey, that might give you life advice. Get some money, get some money, money, get some money. Get some money, get some money, money, get some money. Get some money, get some money, money, get some money. Get some money, get some money, money, get some money. Get some money. It's the paper towel pastor, burning rubber faster than a car on NASCAR. My solo, no sir, I am not a passer. I will not after any of you fever blitzing. I'm the man now, ain't I, work a plan now. Can I? I remember when you lame player, hated a player, now the same lame player. They call a player male.
Say, what you talking
that funky, dip about my face, wearing that monkey, we put in. Not that might give you life advice. Get some money.
So many memories that I made on Cascade Road. I done gained the world, I ain't never sell my soul. This is God-given, so I thank him as I go. Hate to sound conceited, but I know. Crazy thing they with me. Yeah, crazy thing they with me.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the heart of Texas and the very wonderful AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Dallas Cowboys. Brett Maher has this one teed up, and we are underway here at AT&T Stadium. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. As they start on the ground. And this will leave them a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Up at the 29 now, they'll head to the line, second and a yard. Burrow going to fake to Mixon and now look to throw. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Oh, I saw this one with defensive eyes because even as he escaped the pocket and bought time, the coverage stayed tight. Nothing broke down. Throwing it away, that was his only option.
They give to Mixon to try to pick it up, and he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They go play action with Burrow. And his throw here is incomplete.
Nice play on the football, and while it was tipped in the air and made everyone a little bit anxious before falling to the ground, you just know defensive players are taught to knock the ball to the ground. But early in games, emotions come into play, nerves come into play, and despite the training, the ball was tipped up. Fortunately for them, they didn't pay for that error.
Second down, here's Mixon. And he's got a Bengals first down as good running gets him to about the 44.
They did tell us they wanted to establish the ground game early, didn't they?
They did, in a small sample size that we've seen so far, but pretty good return.
Yeah, you got to like that. They've strung together a couple of first downs. Established what they wanted, the running game. And guess what? They also got their lead guy running it pretty well, too.
Throwing now, Burrow on first down. He's going to look deep down the field. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Malik Hooker. And the Cowboys are going to get possession here as they force the opening drive turnover. They may have thrown the interception, obviously less than ideal, but I think they also sent a message that they're going to push the ball downfield in this one.
Yeah, not afraid to take their shots right away, huh? What was that, like a 9-9-9 route? 9 meaning go? Just went ahead and went for it. Didn't work out so well because it certainly appeared the defense was prepared. But I'm with you. Okay, so it didn't work this time. Doesn't mean we won't try it again later.
Not a huge carry there on first down, but not all of them will be. But still, all in all, a positive play for the offense. It's all about picking up at least a few to set up what you're going to do here on second down.
Meanwhile, Prescott's throw complete into the hands of Schultz here. Prescott on first down. And this is caught. It's Brown. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. That one goes for 24 yards. So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a first and 10 at the 34. Throw left side complete. That's Ferguson. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. So they'll get 8 out of that completion, and they'll be left with 2nd and a couple. Really been an ideal start for them. They get the turnover on the opening possession. Now here they are moving the ball straight down the field on their first drive.
And that feels good, but you know on their side of the field, all they're thinking is finish this drive off because they took it away, right? So now you've got them back on their heels a little bit. Now go down, put a touchdown on them. Look out. You've won the mental battle early in the game, and that may carry over for you.
First down, Prescott. Over the middle, complete. It's Brown. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. 18 yards that time to push him up, first and goal. They clearly wanted to come out, Charles, and be aggressive throwing the football, and they've been pretty efficient along with that aggressiveness. He's now 4-for-4 on this opening drive.
Yeah, that's led to a fresh set of downs. I like it.
And it's intercepted at the goal line. And the Bengals are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. CD, when he went to throw that, I'm not sure if he just didn't see where the defense was. Whatever the case, not the throw you're looking for on first and goal.
Not at all, because, look, let's face it, that close to the goal line, if you throw an interception, it's going to hurt on any down. But really, the only down you can kind of live with is if you do it on fourth down. The first three, if you don't have it wide open, just get rid of it. Make sure they can't get it and live to fight another down. First and goal, if you throw the pick, not good at all.
Off the play fake, here's Burrow. They'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's third down.
That's an early scramble if you view positively by either side. From the offensive point of view, it begins to establish it as a possibility to keep it on certain plays. And defensively, they're going to give up a huge play in one of their first tests in containing a quarterback on the run.
And on third down, the Cowboys bring in an extra defensive back. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. Open receiver, that's Hayden Hurst, the tight end. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
Here we go.
Well, a lot of times when you get a manageable third down situation like this, you have to think about your tight end, and he comes through for him, picking up the first down.
Again, that's Hurst. So just 3 yards on the completion there, and it's second down.
Hey, let's face it, you can put any Halloween costume on him. You're not going to be able to disguise him, because for a tight end of his size, difficult to sneak him anywhere, but that's what they tried to do. Lined up on his right, tried to work his way back to his left, but just a minimal gain as the defense was able to react quickly.
In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. From midfield now, Burrow. And that is incomplete.
Well, certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
Fourth down, here's Joe Burrow. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. He's got room at the 30. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. That certainly went against the traditional ways of playing football, but who cares? Look at the result. Big touchdown.
They went for it on their own side of the 50. So there's conservative, there's aggressive, and there's really aggressive, which is what we just saw there. Tip of the cap to them.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. Taken at the goal line. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. On play action, Prescott. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Dalton Schultz, 31 yards. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from drawing level. And oh, he clanks it off the right upright. And it's no good. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
Here we go, here we go.
The Bengals drive about to get going.
And the football changing hands here as this offense takes a field. Charles, they'd be fine with more of the same on this upcoming drive. Last time out, they found the end zone for six.
They're certainly hoping for more of the same, but the game plan, I doubt it'll just be a carbon copy of the last drive, because I think this offense is ready to break out some new wrinkles and try some new things that might be hidden in their playbook. They want to use that confidence to its advantage while also keeping the defense from anticipating what's up next.
Here we go.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run.
11.
Now Burrow. He'll drop this one down to Mixon, and they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. On third and 1, Burrow. Pass thrown right back to Joe Mixon. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 36. The Bengals passing game finding a rhythm. They've got another first. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now it's Burrow. Got a man open. It's Chase.
And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
Throwing again on second down, Burrow. He gets this one to Boyd. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. They'll give it to Mixon. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Now another timeout called for by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Now it's Burrow. And he's got it. Touchdown, Bengals. Hayden Hurst as the first half is winding down. And the Bengals will extend their lead here just before halftime. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And the lead is up to 8. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it. And we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it. We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved. Call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Prescott. Flush to his right. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. It's the Cowboys who get the football first, and they trail here as well as we resume action in the third quarter. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive.
Well, Charles, we saw a pretty entertaining first half, close ball game. Remember there toward the end of the second quarter, the opposition scored to take the lead. Now we'll see if these guys can get a score of their own to regain that lead.
Yeah, they want to have that type of a response, don't they? Because they want to find a way to take control of this ball game one more time. Gauntlet's been thrown down. They want to see if they're ready to answer it.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Now Prescott.
He's got a man complete. And he'll be marked down at about the 26-yard line.
And that might be exactly where they needed to wake up this home crowd. They haven't given them much to cheer for so far. And never underestimate the effect the home crowd with you can have on a game.
So now then, the big play has them all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Play action now, Prescott.
Swinging this out for Pollard. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here.
From the 17, Prescott. Pollard here once again, back-to-back catches. And they're going to be set up now with a ball at the 13-yard line.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover it before he gets going?
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. On the counter, Elliott. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott, a 13-yard touchdown run. And the Cowboys are back within a couple of the lead. Prescott, they're going to throw for it. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
They made the decision to go for two. They didn't get it. They remained down by 2 points. Should they have kicked it there?
Third quarter, I'm okay with it. Maybe first or second, you don't. I don't know. What do you think?
Yeah, I'm again, I keep coming back to, I don't like to chase a lot of points, but I also don't know what kicking an extra point being down one does for me.
Bengals drive about to get going. But Charles, they still have the lead despite their defense giving up a touchdown on the previous possession. And even though they have that lead, it feels like a back-and-forth ball game where to try to get momentum back, maybe they need at least three here on this drive.
I think you're right about that, Brandon, because your game plan doesn't change. I do believe your urgency does because of the last score that went against your team. So what you want to do now is have your own drive and try and make sure that that momentum stays in your camp.
Burrow going to give this to Mixon. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of two, and it brings up second down.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Yeah, every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Now on second and 13, Burrow. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. A good pickup there, 26 yards. And they go play action now. Burrow out to his left. Incomplete.
His back has been a dependable safety valve all game, so he went back to him when his first read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
Third quarter of a two-point game, a good one so far. Here's second and 10. They're passing here, Joe Burrow. This goes out wide for Mixon. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line.
I think the best offenses love to get the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, we saw him shed a nice tackle on that play. So third and two, this quite possibly four-down territory, though, if they're stopped. Mixing up the middle. And he'll be brought down at about the 42.
There we go.
Johnson.
And good work there in open space. And he's got this all the way down now to the 32.
That's a fourth down pickup of 10 yards and an opportunity certainly missed on the defensive side.
So they convert on fourth, and now from just outside the 30, here's first and 10.
Mixon with a first down carry. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20.
54 yards rushing for him now as he's run it 11 times.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive, because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense gets a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard.
Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Micah Parsons.
And the Cowboys are going to get the football back as time will run out in this third quarter of play. So it'll be a change of possession on the turnover when we get back. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
A golden opportunity for them now following the interception. They need to try to at least get three. Obviously, a touchdown puts them in a much more secure position.
7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a second and three. Prescott from the gun. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Elliott. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. Puts it on the carpet, it's out, and the Bengals grab it. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
A disappointing end of the sequence there. He was starting to turn nothing into something, and then he lost the football.
And sometimes things get lost in the transition. And what I mean by that is you go from being a passer to a runner. And at a certain point, once you cross the line of scrimmage, you're strictly a runner now. There's no more downfield threat. Make sure you take care of the football while you're traversing downfield.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw.
And this one too low.
Well, you know me, whether you need it or not, I'm going to give a little unsolicited advice. Just throw it downfield out of the pocket only if you're absolutely sure. Otherwise, use your running ability and try to get those yards a safer way.
Inside handoff to Mixon. 5 yards. Now it's third and five.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Here we go. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Burrow looking to pass. Touchdown, Bengals!
Joe Mixon,
his second touchdown of the night.
And the Bengals get an important score there to extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Well, forget about the weapons out wide. He knows he's got another weapon in the backfield of the passing game, Charles, and he utilized him perfectly on that play.
And the offense coordinator showed me something on that play, Brandon, because so often during a game, our cameras find them looking down at their play sheets, and you wonder if they're absorbing anything. He had something specific in mind, and he went to it, and it worked well.
This fielded right at the goal line.
Now a crease here as he's past the 30.
Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive.
Yeah, the script really is flipped for them. The momentum on the other sideline, and now they have to try and battle back from a two-score deficit.
Dak dropping this one off for Zeke.
Second down and 7.
From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
Nowhere to go downfield, but he's able to get out of bounds and stop the clock here with a first down. To throw is Prescott. Open man downfield is Lamb. It's complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. On first and 10, Prescott. That is caught by Lamb. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. Here's Prescott. And this ball is caught by Lamb. Touchdown, Dallas. The 3-yard touchdown pass. And the Cowboys have made it a one-score game again here in the 4th. Extra point by Moore. Up and good. And now things get a little interesting here in this 4th quarter. Following the touchdown, here's Moore to kick it away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. The Bengals drive about to get going. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have 3 timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit. And you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it 3 times and punt it, you got another thing coming.
Yeah, and by the way, also the 2-minute warning in play, so essentially 4 timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here. That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
I have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up 2nd and 7. Now it looks like he'll throw here. Now look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. And the Cowboys are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line. Oh my, how the tables have turned now. They were trying to salt this one away, but that interception, potentially a game changer.
And I just got to think to myself, at this point of the game, I know you've been aggressive. I know that's your MO, and that's fine. And all those teams that talk about all gas, no brakes, you better have the emergency lever to pull occasionally. They could have used it right there. They put themselves in a tough spot with that interception.
The first down carry by Elliott. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming 2nd down play. Straight ahead here with Pollard. They find some open field here. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. Now a 2nd timeout called for by the defense. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the 1st down. Now here's Pollard. And he is not going to get through here on try number 1. They stop him at the goal line. Now the Bengals going to signal for their 3rd and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming 2nd down play. They'll try to run it in with Elliott.
And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line. Chalk that up as a 4-yard loss, and now it's third down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they start.
He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth. Extra point by Moore, and good. And the lead is up to 5. Following the touchdown, here's Moore to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Bengals drive about to get going. And the points, they have come fast and furious in this quarter.
You really don't want to be on the defensive side of the ball right now, do you? Because you're either thinking, my replacement may get an opportunity.
Your head better be on a swivel.
Totally. Or maybe I just need to get out of the game for a while, because I just can't slow these guys down. They've got to figure out a way to disrupt these offenses. And typically, one guy makes a big play, and that can help change things.
They'll be looking for disruption on both sides right now. Burrow. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. The way he's throwing the football today, almost a surprise when he doesn't complete a pass like happened there, but he needs a few more to get his guys downfield.
Well, the way he's throwing it leads him to believe that he's going to get those completions. And that means the guys going out for passes, they'll run even harder because they expect it as well.
And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. You can almost see inside his face mask there the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 11 more on that one, and another first down. To throw, Burrow. And this one incomplete. So the clock stopped now with 20 seconds remaining.
He didn't just deny a big throw there. He broke that one up in the red zone. An excellent play, one that may help save points on the board when this drive is over.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. Now Burrow. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. They'll wind up losing 10 on the sack, and it'll lead to a 3rd and long.
Partner, what a finish to this one. I mean, this offense, they had it down there inside the red zone, but ultimately couldn't execute that final snap to find the end zone.
Yeah, and they're going to walk away from this one, and you know it's going to go through their heads the entire time until they get to play again. If we could only have that final snap to do over one more time, maybe with a different play call.